Hi friends, this is Uday Bhanu. Hope you are doing well at your homes. As the picture itself says, today I am going to discuss about limbus. Limbus, as we all know that it is junction or a border between cornea and sclera and also cornea and conjunctiva. So we may wonder that why this small structure is so important to us, because it contains aqueous outflow and also several stem cells. What we know is up to this, let's go into details about this limbus. So this limbus is formed where the radius of curvature of cornea and radius of curvature of sclera changes abruptly at some point, and that is limbus. So limbus is the area where the radius of curvature of cornea and sclera changes abruptly, and this radius of curvature changes and this forms externally an external scleral sulcus and internally an internal scleral sulcus. If you can see in the diagram, I have labeled in red arrow, that is external scleral sulcus, and some black arrow, that is internal scleral sulcus. Sorry that I couldn't get a better picture than this. So what is there behind this internal scleral sulcus is there is scleral spur and canal of Sclem. So besides aqueous outflow, limbus also contains some stem cells, and these stem cells are located in palisades of Wogt. So palisades of Wogt are nothing but some radially arranged ridges which contain limbal stem cells. Now externally, the limbal epithelial cells between the conjunctiva and cornea are multipotent. So these cells help in differentiation of conjunctiva and cornea. Internally, between corneal endothelium and trabeculum, there also limbal stem cells are present. These are useful for regeneration, especially in any trabecular injuries, for example in laser trabeculoplasty. So here are some pictures depicting what I just said now. So you can see in the diagram, the limbal stem cells first changed into transient amplifying cells, then into post mitotic and terminal differentiating cells. And so these cells are useful for differentiation of cornea and conjunctiva. This diagram shows cornea, conjunctiva and the limbus. And this diagram shows cornea, sclera and the limbus, the palisades of Wogt. So this is a diagram depicting three of them in a single picture. That is cornea, limbus, conjunctiva and sclera. So let's get into the blood supply of limbus. Blood supply of limbus is mainly through anterior ciliary artery. So superficial branches and perforating branches from anterior ciliary artery supply the limbus. Let's see it in a pictorial way. If you can see in the diagram, superficial branches are supplying the conjunctiva and peripheral cornea. Perforating branches supply structures deep to the limbus and also the anterior ovea. Limbal stem cells are mostly present on superior and inferior quadrants than in nasal and temporal quadrants. So what are the functions of limbus? Limbus prevents conjunctivalization of cornea. It also helps in trabecular injury, as we already discussed. And limbal stem cells are important that their deficiency causes several outcomes. So guys, let's have a look at this table. This table is differences between cornea, limbal and bulbar conjunctival epithelium. May be useful for you in your entrance exams. I just want to mention an important clinical sign here, that is limbus sign. It is nothing but the ring of dystrophic calcification, which is white in color. I think you can see the black arrow mark showing the white ring, that is limbus sign. So differential diagnosis for this is arcus senilis. This is a general view of limbus, I mean what happens at the limbus. I'm not stressing this here. If you want, please have a look at it. Some important clinical relevance regarding this limbus. Usually the tenon capsule do not extend towards the anterior side completely. There is a zone between tenon capsule and the cornea. So in that zone, after any full thickness glaucoma surgery, there is a high chance of developing cystic blebs over the area. And during the embryological development, the endothelial layer of the cornea covers the trabecular meshwork, but it usually gets retracted during the third trimester. If it still persists there, then it may cause secondary glaucoma. Because the cornea and between trabecular meshwork there is limbus, and it is responsible for aqueous outflow. So as endothelium is covering this limbal area, it leads to secondary glaucoma. In similar way, there is high chance of Desmond's membrane gets proliferated onto the trabecular meshwork, especially after trabeculoplasties. This may cause iridocorneal endothelial syndrome, where Desmond's membrane gets proliferated and limbal area gets blocked and thus aqueous outflow and leading to secondary angle glaucoma. So guys, this is my way of explaining limbus. If you understood very well and if it is any way useful to you, don't forget to like, share, subscribe and also comment your views on this video. Until then, bye bye.